We are here at the Kansas City Zoo today looking at the baby otters. New baby otters are going on display today for the first time to the public. I'm Emily Welsh here with Sean Putney from the Kansas City Zoo, and these guys were just looking at them sleeping, their little otter pile. How adorable.
Is it not the most cute thing you've ever seen?
I can't even handle it. It is so precious. Yeah, so they do this a lot of the day?
Well, they do. There's a lot of sleeping that goes on, but of course the youngsters, just like human babies, they need their rest.
Yeah.
So they'll go out and play and swim and get tired out, and then they'll go back for a rest, and all the family, as you can see, mom, dad, big brother, and somewhere in the middle of that pile are the two newest additions. They were born on March 17th. So
St. Patrick's Day babies.
Right. So Conner and Clover. And
love it.
In commemoration of being born on St. Patrick's Day, we put it out there for votes, and that's what the public came back with. So you can see on the far end of the exhibit now, our keepers are going to get their attention. So they have some fish.
Oh, nice. It's an early lunchtime.
They definitely have their attention now.
Oh, boy.
I think that's younger. Nope, that's one of the parents.
Wandering over.
Going over.
Oh,
so they'll grab some
adorable
fish. They'll probably take some over the youngsters,
aww,
too. But the youngsters are old enough now where they can go grab their own fish, too, if they wanted to.
Yeah. But mom and dad still feed them.
Yeah,
they're still their
protective
babies.
This is really the first time that they're out on exhibit, so you can see the ramps that are in the water. The mom and dad are teaching them how to swim. They aren't born with the knowledge of being able to swim, so mom and dad have to teach them and go through being the lifeguards. Obviously very excited over there.
They are. There he goes, diving in after it, just like in the wild.
So obviously you can see them feeding fish. They are carnivores. So,
is that what they typically
eat?
They
also have to learn to hunt. They live in big family groups. They can, in the wild, you might see them in groups of up to 20. So it's not like some animals that prefer to live by themselves or just in pairs. They accept being with their family for a long period of time.
They have a whole clan there. Right. So explain how, I mean, I know this is their first day out in public and in this big exhibit. So explain how you helped the little babies learn to swim and kind of get acclimated.
So our keeper staff does a great job of making sure that the animals are being well taken care of. And in their back area where their bedrooms are, they put these little pools in. And so they'll fill them up with just a little bit of water at a time and let them get comfortable, and there's ramps that go into it so they can get in and out safely. And then mom and dad will dictate how long and if they should be going in the water. And in fact, there was some struggles this time because mom and dad were being a little bit overprotective, and they'd go in to search, and mom and dad would pull them out.
Oh.
So this is really the deepest water that they've been in, and mom and dad have been teaching them how they think they've been in too long, they'll pull them out, but they've been taking them on little dives and shoving them down in the water to see what it's like to hold their breath for a longer period of time.
Wow.
It's pretty neat to see.
Almost like human parents teaching little
right
ones to
that's
swim.
Right.
That is so funny. But the little ones, we can see they're growing pretty fast. They're only like 3 months old.
They're 3 months old, and you have to remember that most animals grow pretty quickly, because if they don't, then they're not going to be able to survive in the wild. And give themselves their own food and help the family hunt for food.
Mm-hmm.
There are some animals that take longer periods of time, but a lot of them have to get up and mobile fairly quickly.
So how many times a day will they eat like this?
For the most part, they get a couple of meals per day. They'll eat a little bit more, and they're still getting food from mom, too. So that hasn't been over yet, but they'll continue to get more and more fish as the days go by and months go by, until finally that's all they eat. And their older brother, they're very prolific. Their older brother's only 9 months old.
Wow. So, but he looks bigger than the parents almost.
Well, he's a little bit shy. He's still a little bit smaller than them. But again, they can build a group size pretty quickly.
Yeah. There's so many. But I just love that they really do kind of have that sense of family when we watch them all huddled in the corner together and squirming and just cuddling.
And very protective.
It's, yeah.
The staff has talked about making sure that they're being wary of where the parents are, because they're very protective of their kids.
Yeah.
As they're growing, especially after they're just born, The staff would have to wait for the parents to come out and switch over into another stall in order to go in and get the weights for the youngsters and make sure that they were both growing at the pace that they needed to be. So it's really a lot of our staff working with mom and dad, making sure everything's going well.
We've had some questions from viewers on our Facebook page because we knew we were going to be seeing the otters. So Cody asked, how deep in the water can otters actually go?
Out in the wild, you're probably talking about 30 or 40 feet.
Wow.
They're excellent swimmers, can hold their breath for a while.
Yeah.
In here, the water is about 3 feet deep, I'd say it's max.
Yeah.
So we limit that a little bit in here.
Yeah. So also, as we're looking at how cute and cuddly and adorable these otters are, one person, April, asked, can you have an otter as a pet?
Well, I'm sure that there are some people out there that have tried, and this is something that we do talk about quite a bit here at the zoo. Even though they are cute and cuddly and they just look adorable like a plush animal, there's a lot of things that they need. And again, they have very sharp teeth, and I would discourage people from wanting to go out there and get an animal like an otter or there are some animals out there that live for a really long time, like certain species of birds that they look like they'd be a great pet, but they really probably wouldn't be.
So leave it to the pros,
professionals. Come and see them at the zoo.
Exactly. Just come here and hang out with them. Aaron asked, where do otters sleep? Do they sleep in those little nests like we saw?
They do. They make themselves little nests. If you were to see them out in Southeast Asia, they can make little burrows. So in the side of the hillside, that might be right beside where a stream or an outlet is. In here, we do give them nest boxes for when we feel that they're about to give birth. Mm-hmm. So they do have that den sort of feeling. But as you can see where they were sleeping before, they were building themselves a little nest made out of some bamboo strips.
And you mentioned East Asia. These are Asian small clawed, right?
Asian small clawed
otters. So what's the difference between that and maybe the river otters that we see?
These are much smaller. And the nice thing is at the zoo, we actually have North American river otters. So you can compare the two.
Oh, cool.
And there are several different species of otters, but those are the two that we have here. Certainly not the biggest of animals. Our North American river otter is fairly big when you compare them to some other ones. These are fairly small. And the North American river otter is found right here in Missouri. So you might actually see
them pretty cool.
Out in the Blue River or
in the river.
Missouri.
Wow, how neat is that? But you won't see these guys anywhere but right here in Missouri.
Correct.
That's awesome. Now, how long do otters live?
Well, a really old otter is going to be in their 20s. But as we always say, there's going to be a variation, and some of that's based on genetics.
Mm-hmm.
Out in the wild, they're certainly not going to live longer than they would here at a zoo setting. They're getting all sorts of great care. Our veterinary staff is wonderful in making sure that they're nice and healthy, as well as our husbandry staff. So Kai is 11 years old. That's the mom. The dad is 7 years old. So that's about middle age as far as otters go.
And we're watching them right now just playing, kind of playing with each other in the water, wrestling around. It almost is like watching, you know, human kids or your own kids. How much time do they spend in the water compared to land?
Again, they do spend a lot of time resting. During the daytime hours, they might be in there for several hours.
Yeah.
And probably, again, if you were to see them out in Southeast Asia, they'd spend more time in the water because of the fact that they're constantly hunting for food.
Mm-hmm.
Here, they get a little bit of a break.
They're
bringing them food.
They got it easy. So one person, Mark, wrote on our Facebook page something that was interesting. He said that otters clean themselves after every meal.
So why
do they do that? Yeah, they're just very, very clean and proper.
And they'll groom each other as well. So making sure that their fur is very important as far as making sure that their heat is kept in too. Because as we all know, getting in the water, you get cold quick.
Yeah, true.
So any otter has very thick fur and more hairs per square inch, much more hairs per square inch than we do. And that's so that when they get in the water, they have that insulation factor to help them keep warm. You would think in Southeast Asia, it'd be the opposite. You would not want to have as much hair, but the water really plays into that.
Yeah. Oh, so many interesting things. You really are an expert on these guys. I love it. So is there anything else that you want the public to know as they come and see these guys kind of for the first time?
Well, hopefully this is the first time. Otis was the first time we had a successful breeding pair.
Yeah.
And we opened up this building in 2009. So we've been working our way towards this this moment, so to speak. But hopefully we'll have some more youngsters as time goes by, and we'll continue to see see more family action with the otters. And again, like you said, they're very fun to watch. They're very active. When they're not sleeping, they're very active and interactive. So it makes for a much much more fun exhibit for the people who are visiting to see.
Yeah. Well, how big can these otters get? I mean, are the parents...
Mom and dad are full size.
Fully. That's pretty much a normal size for these guys. It's not too bad. I'm trying to see if the babies... I don't think they've ventured into the water yet right now.
I see one of them over on the log.
Maybe. Yeah, he's thinking about it. He's looking over the ledge like, okay, maybe. So, it's cute. So you said these ramps are for the babies, right?
Right.
To help them get in.
Realistically, they could probably get out on their own. There are several places where otters can climb out.
Yeah.
But it's just a secondary measure just in case, because they are beginner swimmers.
Yeah.
Just like the shallow end of the pool for new humans beginning to figure out how to swim around.
Oh, the babies, look, they're looking in like they might do it. Maybe.
Almost.
They're a little nervous. But like you said, mom and dad are protective, so they've been...
They are, and there's a lot of activity going on with all the food. So, now they're out of food.
Aww.
So,
well, so cute.
Maybe they'll venture in.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for spending time with us today to teach us and talk to us.
Sure.
This is definitely the highlight of my week.
Thanks for coming in.
Awesome. And then next week you're talking red pandas, right?
So we're hoping that the red panda female is pregnant. We're not real sure. So we're going to do some
more babies.
Show some training and what the keeper staff does to see if they truly are pregnant. So they work with our animal health staff to do some sonograms and things along those lines.
Wow.
and see if there really is any in there. We're not real sure quite yet, but we'll show you some training that the keeper staff does.
Awesome. All right, Sean, thank you so much.
Thank
Thanks,
you.
Everyone, for watching. See you next time.